Hi, I'm Clint Rutkas. I'm the lead for PowerToys, and I'm here to tell you all about it. So, you might ask yourself, what is PowerToys, and why is it relevant to me? Well, PowerToys is an installable suite of utilities that's built in collaboration with the community in open source. It helps customize features in Windows 10 and add in additional utilities to make you and your workflow more optimal. An example of a few of these PowerToys utilities are a color picker, a window management system we call FancyZones, and we have six additional utilities also I'd love to talk to you about in a couple of minutes. So what is the origin story to PowerToys? Well, way back in the day with Windows 95 and Windows XP, there's a group of utilities that were built by Microsoft engineers to make their lives easier. And they said, hey, this was a really cool group of utilities, and they made them available to everyone. Fast forward to Windows 10, a bunch of people came in internally and were like, hey, this would be a really great utility. Wouldn't it be nice if we could make it public to everyone? And we decided to make it open source and show the community how we're building out these utilities to help make their lives better. So how do you install and try PowerToys? Well, it's extremely easy. All you need to do is go to aka.ms/install-powertoys, and that will bring you to the release tab in our GitHub repository. If you just go to the front page of GitHub, you'll be greeted to this screen that you see right here. You just click the top release candidate, and you go down to our exe file here in assets, click it, and download it to your local computer. Here, I'm saving it to my desktop, so it'll take a second to download. I'm going to double click it, and then you'll see the install wizard come up. Click next a few times, and then PowerToys will auto start once the installer finishes up. I'm going to click finish, and I'm going to go and say, no, I don't need to restart Explorer. And here you can see PowerToys is now fully started. I'm going to double click on the settings, and you can see it's operational. So let's quickly run through all our PowerToys. So here you can see the settings screen. So let's go quickly launch the color picker. To do color picker, the default keystroke is Shift Window C. And here you can see it come up, and you can see the color of the different colors underneath. So let's say I want this black. Just click it. I'm going to go pull up Notepad really quick. And I'm going to paste it, and you can see here it gave me a hex value. If I go back and grab this blue, same thing. It's that exact color. But now let's say that doesn't work for you. Let's grab an RGB value, and let's grab one of these blues from the ocean. Click it, and it gives you the RGB value. Super easy, super quick, and it's fully customizable to what keystroke works best for you. So let's talk about FancyZones, our quick window layout management system. So first, we're going to launch our editor to show which zones we currently want. For my computer, I have a priority grid with 5 zones built into it. If I wanted to, I could set a column grid of 3, a grid of 6, whatever you want. You can also create fully customizable layouts also. But for me, I like using a priority grid of 5. I'm going to click Apply. And also, I have a couple settings here that are not default that work best for me, and that's overriding arrow snap. I like it when my windows resize when they're unsnapped, and I also enjoy having my windows be transparent when I drag them. So to use FancyZones, all you need to do is hold down Shift. So let's go open up an instance of Terminal and an instance of Notepad. And I'm going to hold down Shift, and I'm going to click the title bar, and here you can see it kick in. So all I'm doing is just holding Shift and dragging around my window. I'm going to put Notepad in Zone 2. And then for Terminal, let's bring Terminal into Zones 3 and 5. So here I'm holding down shift and I'm going in between the break. Now, wouldn't it be great if also you can make them any size you want? So here I'm going to hold down shift, control, and drag the title bar. And I'm going to go grab zones 1, 2, and 3. And it's that simple, just by holding down control and shift. And that's fancy zones. Up next is File Explorer Additions. So here we have the PowerToy folder, and you can see we have Markdown, SVG files, HTML files. Here, and I also have my preview pane open. So if you've never used the preview pane built into File Explorer, just click View and click Preview Pane, and this pane will open up. So if I select a test.html, you can see right here an HTML file fully renders. Well, there are two file formats that developers are using more and more, SVG and Markdown, and they aren't actually preview pane capable. So anyways, we've enabled that. So if I click Markdown, you can see here's the full Markdown file for the roadmap for PowerToys. Also, same thing with this SVG. So I have the SVG open here, and as you can see, we also have a thumbnail in File Explorer. Wouldn't it be? Now, this is something that didn't exist before. You weren't able to see the thumbnail of the SVG. So we've added in this ability. I'm going to change the color from green to red really quick and hit save. You can see in real time, we've updated the thumbnail and the SVG as well. Next, we have Image Resizer. Image Resizer does just what it sounds like. It resizes images and allows you to do bulk image resizing. So quickly, I'm going to hit Shift Window S to do a screen capture here. I'm just going to grab my screen. Because I have focus mode on, I'm going to go grab this screenshot really quick and save it to my desktop. I'm going to drag it into everyone's favorite PowerToys folder. I'm going to right click on this file, and you can see right here it says resize pictures. So I'm going to go and make it a small image and resize it. And right here you can see the screenshot says small. And in my in the about, you can see it says a height of 480 versus the actual screenshot was a height of 705. So let's just open it up really quick. And you can definitely tell the difference between the two images. Next is Keyboard Manager. Keyboard Manager is a powerful remapping tool to let you do key-to-key, key-to-shortcut, shortcut-to-shortcut, and shortcut-to-key remappings. Now, you might ask, why do you need this? But there's instances where you might be used to different keyboards. Your native language is a different language, and different languages have different keyboards. So you want your muscle memory to work exactly how it's used to. So I'm going to show you a very trivial example of remapping keys, and then I'm going to show you a really powerful way to use the shortcut remapping to make your life more powerful in an application, for instance. So here I'm going to go remap key A to key B. I'm going to click OK. So I'm hitting A and I'm getting B. But if you don't believe me, let's go start up our on-screen keyboard. And I'm going to go tip A and B. And you can see it's fully remapped. So let's delete that key binding. I'm going to go back to my keyboard. I'm going to click A again. Oops. And now you can see it fully remapped the key. So let's talk about remapping shortcuts and where this might become very, very powerful. So I'm going to go remap Control F, which most people would say would be finding something. And randomly, I'm just going to type F4. And this is going to make more sense as soon as I include everyone's favorite email client, Outlook. So I have this email from Matt, and I really am interested in finding some text here because he has a word that I really like, and it's promotion. So I'm going to hit Control F, and the find and replace prompt comes up. So if I type in pro, it's going to find promotion. Now let's delete this key remap. And if I hit Control F now, it actually forwards the email. This is one of those shortcuts where I always use Control F to find, but Outlook does things slightly differently. So I want to be able to override that capability. And Keyboard Manager allows you to do that. Next is PowerRename. PowerRename is a bulk renaming tool. So you can use regular expressions or just something basic like a single word. So let's go back to our PowerToys folder here, and I'm going to highlight all these roadmap copies because some person decided to copy a bunch of files, make copies of copies and copies versus using proper source code management. So here I'm going to go right click on these and go to Power Rename. And I'm going to search for the word copy, and you can see in real time the renaming here. I'm just going to click rename, and it's going to rename all my files on my file system. Now we're going to talk about PowerToys Run. It's a quick launcher that has additional capabilities without sacrificing performance. Here you can remap what the key shortcut is, along with show more and less results, and do a couple other additional options. For me, I like using window key space, so let's go remap that. So if I hit window key space, you can see PowerToys Run come up. Here I'm just going to type term, and terminal comes up exactly what you expect. But type code, Visual Studio Code. You can do things like run it as an administrator, open up the containing folder, or even open up the path in console. So if I click that or hit enter, you'll see Visual Studio Code run, or terminal, for instance, and terminal will open up. It's extremely quick, extremely fast, extremely intuitive. Finally, we have shortcut guide. Now, you might be asking yourself, I'm a power user, why do I need a shortcut guide? Well, I'm willing to bet there's probably a couple shortcuts you may not know of. So our team came up with a list of shortcuts right now that we thought were very, very relevant. So if you hold down window key, you'll get this dialog that comes up and shows you different options you can do for the current context. So if I hit window key 2, Outlook would open. If I hit window key left, that window would snap to the left. Or a new one I learned was window key comma temporarily lets you peek at your desktop. So there's always new things that you can learn and become that much more of a power user. There's occasionally times where you're going to use applications that need to be run as admin. So this is a scenario I want to directly call out because there are three instances in PowerToys where we use system hooks that need to be running as the same level as the other applications that are using this, namely administrator. So if you can see on my screen here, I have Windows Terminal up and that's running as administrator. And to be able to use FancyZones with this, FancyZones also needs to be run as administrator. So to do that, all you need to do is restart PowerToys as administrator. Now, if PowerToys notices any application that is running higher level than what it is, it will inform you as a user through a system notification. But I'm just going to show this to you really quick as running it elevated. So I just click run as admin. I click the user prompt. And here you can see now I'm running as administrator. And if I always want to run it as administrator, you can click the box. It's not something we suggest doing, though. So now if I hold down shift and move my terminal window around, you can see everything starts working again. So what does it mean that PowerToys is open source? Well, it means that everything we do, it's under the MIT license and it's done in the open. So if you want to clone or fork our repository, you're more than welcome to. We also accept pull requests from you, the community, which means you can contribute back. So Here is our repository. All you need to do to get started is copy our URL, go to Visual Studio, and clone the repository. You click clone, and Visual Studio will grab everything you need. Now, there are a few dependencies if you were to do this, and you just go down to our developer documents down here, where it says developer guidance, you click there, and it will tell you exactly how to set up your computer and the rules and the contribution guidelines to contribute back to PowerToys. There are many different ways you can actually contribute back to PowerToys. You can file a feature request, help out with design, file bugs if you find any. You can help out with documentation, and heck, help out with spelling, because gosh knows I need it. And you can also help out with actual active development of new features. So if you're interested in what PowerToys is currently working on, you can check out our project tab. That will show you month over month what issues and features we're proactively thinking about. In addition, we're right now thinking about our 2021 roadmap and what new features and enhancements we're going to add into PowerToys. So tabs versus spaces, my opinion is do what works best for that language along with what your team's guidelines are. So a great example of what works best for a language is YAML. YAML is space-based. So you kind of have to use it. It's not something to pick a fight on. Now, if you really want to troll someone, now, and your name was Rich Turner, who's on my team, when we were testing out Keyboard Manager, we may have put tab and space and reversed the order on him. Thanks for spending some time with me today to learn about PowerToys. If you'd like a deeper dive overview on any of our utilities, please check out our wiki. And if you want to contribute, please go to the GitHub repository page. If you want to follow me on Twitter, my username is @ClintRutkas. If you like tabs versus spaces, please hit the subscribe button. And up next will be the GPU acceleration video with Clark.